So what about dance made you so passionate about it? What specifically do you in dance made you feel like, wow, this is something that I want to do for life?
I definitely enjoyed the learning process of it. I definitely enjoyed I think it might have been the lack of connection that I had to people. I love the ability to teach other people. And I think whenever you feel like you can make an impact on someone else's life in a positive way where they actually give you feedback on it, no matter what you're doing, like that is a drug that is super addicting. Like when somebody today wrote this amazing paragraph today, this morning, on what I am does for them. And like, I could even read it to you because it's a great example of what the reason is why I love Inspire Movement and do it more than anything is, she wrote here, "Hey Favian, been out of the I am loop a bit, but I wanted to tell you how important I think your studio is and how much of a difference you and I am have made in my life. You gave me a community when I first moved to Austin and knew nobody. You taught me how to connect better with myself, with my body, and with my emotions. And you taught me how to connect better with others. You taught me the magic that can happen when two bodies become one. And you taught me how my own sensuality without feeling, you taught me how to own my sensuality without feeling sexually objectified. You taught me how to surrender, to follow, to trust. I am eternally grateful. You are bringing really important lessons into the world. You teach consent and respect and boundaries. I wish everyone in the world could go to your studio. Is there anything I can do right now to support you?" So when she wrote that, I was like, oh, wow. My God, you were able to tell me what it is that I'm trying to do through dance. Mm-hmm. Like there's other avenues through yoga, through therapy, through anything that can teach somebody how to do this. But like dance has able for me to connect to some people and help them in this manner. And I want to say this is also helped me with my confidence, helped me with my emotions, helped me to connect better to others, helped me how to become one with another person about my sensuality. Now it's actually, as a leader in dance, I'm still learning and enjoying now how to follow as being a leader, how to follow a person in the way they move before I try to direct their movement, patience, all sure. The above. And then understanding how everybody's different. Just because I know how to lead, every dance is different because every person is different. And now I realize through Good Society how I need to know that my way of communicating is not good for everybody else. Like what makes sense to me and what comes out of my mouth can be absolutely mean nothing from someone else, could offend somebody else if I'm not trying to do that. So I feel like dance has helped me do that. And I feel like I loved just the opportunity to give that and make an impact through dance. Like that's what was my addiction and my passion to dance, was being able to do that for others.
Yeah, and those are all like super life skills that can actually take into the real world and in other situations. I mean, would you agree?
Absolutely. You know, they're able to be more confident, that can help them. They're able to get situated in Austin. If you didn't know anybody and needed a community, it's hard. It was hard for me to go to the bars and meet people at the bars because it's a different atmosphere compared to a different atmosphere of going to a Starbucks to meet people. Mm-hmm. I think dance is a way where you start touching somebody before you even talk to them, before you get to know them. So it almost puts you 2-3 steps into the game before you even start communicating, which is one, nice.
That's huge.
Because you might go to a Starbucks and you only shake their hand before and give a really crappy hug at the end, and everything else was just vocal, versus physical touch is something that some people don't get at work because they might be dealing with just computers and dealing with
it at home too, right?
And then at home, if they're single or if their marriage isn't helping fulfill that need, then they're able to get it without it being cheating, without it being looked down upon, and being able to go deep into sensuality with a stranger, with someone else who's not your significant other, and feed that desire we need in our body without it, you know, being looked down upon or without disrespecting your significant other. So I do feel like,
you know,
that
can help too. I think it's like a running joke within the community when you see someone, two people that don't know each other, they dance so sensual, or they do all these crazy movements that you think, wow, they have to have such an amazing connection with. And then after the dance, they're like, okay, bye. And there's like nothing there anymore. You're like, what?
And then it's so nice to be able to let that part of your personality come out without having to think it means anything else.
Correct. Yeah.
Having, you can't do that at work. You can't move your body, wear that outfit, make those emotions come out at work, because it's not right for work, or it would get you in trouble.